Hello, ladies and gentlemen, this is Best of Slot, and we are back playing Jurassic World, the game, on the iPad thingamajiggy. What are we doing today? Ooh, crikey, didn't mean to do that. What are we doing today? Well, we are doing our Mega Evolution Day that we planned in the last episode. Stop doing that! Double-clicking! Right, before we do that, do we have anything over here? We do, we have a Triceratops in the hatchery, which is lovely. Go ahead and get him out because he's another like. Can you blend? Yes, you can it blend. You can fuse the Triceratops. We're going to keep the extra one. I've started doing this. If we nip down to the. I got a Velociraptor. And if we nip down to said Velociraptor, somewhere around there, I've kept the extra one this time because one day the Velociraptor will be fused. And it's always nice to have an extra one so that we don't lose it altogether like we did with the Diplodocus. Initially, before we got another one, as you can see. Right, so yes, our main goal... What's this? Oh. Our main goal for today is simply get all six of these evolutions done. They have all been prepped. I will show you what I mean. If we go down to our first one, which is over here somewhere. Giganotosaurus. I've set it up, so we've got level 30, a level 20, and level 10s. So that way, for all six, and there's going to be six, ladies and gentlemen, six new level 40 evolutions today. You should be able to see all six of these at all stages of the revolution. Not the basic one, but we've already seen those. So level 10, boop, level 20. So you can see the difference, it's just a little bit stripey. And I love the colour scheme of this guy. I think he looks really good here. And then he kind of goes a bit red and pinky and strange looking. I think it loses something. But hopefully at level 40, well, we know what he looks like at level 40. I think he looks really cool. Let's find out. I'm really excited. Six brand new level 40s, all of them rares. All of them pretty bloody useless in the context of battles and the context of the game, but it'll get the mission done. It's six new ones rather than, you know, leveling up commons again, which would have been easier to an extent maybe, but it's a little bit boring, isn't it? We want to get some excitement. We want some new dinosaurs. And just level this up to 30, and we shall see what he's like at his super evolution. Plus, doing this, this is going to get us a lot more gold. And gold and food have been really good. I've kept clicking all the buttons and such things, but if we can increase our income a little bit more, that's always going to be a good thing. I want to thank you guys as well, as per usual, because you're lovely people. But mainly, he's pretty cool, isn't he? I like the addition of the green and the little horn. He's not gone too overboard. He's got spikes, he's got a horn. Considering what some of them look like, that's pretty, you know, tame. I want to thank you guys because you all commented about layout of the park and stuff like that. One of you in particular, and name I've completely forgotten, gave me a huge, humongously, like, really detailed and really interesting comment. I'm not sure how much of it I'm going to follow, if any, because there was lots of good suggestions, but I just appreciated people getting in touch with that kind of thing. I think the plan we're going to do is split it. I think we are going to split it into carnivores, herbivores, aquatic, pteranodons, and then have the hybrids in the middle section. A few people suggested that. I quite like the idea because I want a centerpiece, you know, and the hybrids, they make sense as that centerpiece. So the hybrids are going to sit here with some buildings and stuff, and then some buildings up here. And I wish they... Why couldn't they give me a nice square park? Why does it have to be weird looking? And then, let's say carnivores. Well, carnivores there, herbivores there. Amphibians here, or what we could do, if we go into the battle arena, no, we'll do that in a bit, if we could organise it so it's got the same formation as that graphic that they give you, you know, where one beats one. I'll show you what I mean in a minute when we hop into the battle arena. Where is our next evolution? One of them is in here, I think. Tapiara, there we go. So, once again, level 10, looking terrifying. Level 20. Looking pretty terrifying. Level 30. Looks pretty cool. Let's go get ourselves a level 40. I'm trying to remember the six. It's Tapiara, Giganotosaurus, the Dilophosaurus, which I'm really excited about, Pyroraptor, Pachycephalosaurus, Parasaurolophus, maybe? There's definitely six, and six is how many we need. I planned this out meticulously. I just happened to then go and forget the names of absolutely everything. Beep, 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 beep. Primal Carnage Extinction needs some skins like this for two Pendaculus. Right, ooh. Looks like fish-esque in that middle a little bit, doesn't he? Oh, come on. I've got tons of DNA, this isn't a problem. But I would like some remaining, so that we can look at getting ourselves some legendaries and stuff after this. It depends what the next mission is, frankly, because I don't have a living clue at the moment. It's looking pretty cool, actually. I mean... Again, I like these ones where they're clearly over the top, but they're not crazy, crazy over the top compared to the actual creature, you know? Tabiara looks very cool, very crazy, but he's not super duper crazy. He's relatively crazy. Right. We're going to save Glophosaurus for last, because I'm most excited about that one. Coryphosaurus, that's the other one, not Parasol Olivus. Oh, yeah. So, level 10, level 20, level 30. Quite subtle, this one. Just green, more green, and a bit of red as well. So I'm just expecting loads of red. Red seems to be a very popular choice. Stick a bit of red on it, people will love it. Actually, saying that, Coryphosaurus, Tapiara, and Giganotosaurus all have done that for their evolution so far. They've just stuck more red on the dinosaur slash creature. Let's see if Coryphosaurus is going to follow suit. I suspect it will. Boing, boing. Does a little dance. I know it's meant to be like an attack, roar, barg, I'm an angry dinosaur, but it doesn't. It looks adorable. Like it's doing a little celebratory... what's that word? Ballet. Ballet is the word I'm looking for there. Okay, he's got a big hat. We can see a big hat. Let's see. Let's see. And his little dance. Whee! He looks like a tropical fruit. Am I crazy? Or does he look like a tropical fruit? Nom 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 nom. It's a tropical fruit. Nom 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 nom. No, he looks so happy when he's numbing. I want to feed him again. Oh! Oh, he looks so happy. Aw, Cory, you're adorable. Next up is Pyroraptor. That's not a Pyro, that's a Utahraptor. Next up is Pyroraptor. Yeah, there we go. Level 10. Level 20. Oh, look, level 30, and it's more red. I never realised this before. This is all they do. They just paint it red. Never mind paint it black. Good song, but it's not relevant here. It's painted red. We're going to paint the town red? No, no, no. We're going to paint Jurassic World red. No colours anymore, I want to paint them red. Doesn't really work when red is a colour. I really like that. It's so fluffy as well. Like you'd want to cuddle it, even if it's going to eat your face. I'm having some great luck with these evolutions as well. I know they're only rares, so they do tend to be pretty blimmin' easy. But still, feels lucky. Kinda looks like a fruit as well. Don't know why, maybe I just really want some fruit right now. Oh well. Sorry, I'll stop with sound effects. We have definitely seen the Pyroraptor. We've seen all of these, I believe. Although, have we seen Dilophosaurus? I don't think we have. Pyroraptor is definitely one of the more subtle ones, isn't it? It's barely changed. It's just a little fluffier and a bit more feathery. Eyes are particularly huge as well. Hello. That noise, guys, that noise. The one just before he jumps did the... Oh, cool. We're very close to a Carnoraptor. We only need... Well, we need four more Carnotauruses. Boop. Pachycephalosaurus, level 10, level 20, level 30. Not red. Not red. Very exciting. Maybe our first not red evolution. We've done six so far. Four so far. I can't count. I've done four so far, and they've all been red. And I think the Dilophosaurus is going to match that. So really, it's going to be one in six is green looking. If they stick with this colour scheme, like a greeny yellow type thing. This could look really cool, this. I don't know if you've seen this one. I'm hoping for like a giant battering ram on its head. No colours anymore, I want to paint them red. But I can't. Because I'm dead. Beep. Nope. Meh. Beep, boop, beep, boop, beep, 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 beep. So how's everyone doing? Everyone doing well? That's nice. Boop, boop, boop. We have seen this because it's got the weird little frilly thing sticking out the back of it, and it looks like a watermelon, which I believe is what I said last time. You can see it there. You can see how watermelon-y. I do like that they've given... Oh my god. Stop it. I do like that they've given them all these individual little unique portraits for each evolution and stuff. I mean, a lot of them are just colorizations. Is that a word? Probably. But some of them, they've really put the effort in. It's a watermelon with a shell. It's really cool. I mean, like, if the head was done a little bit better, because I don't love the head, I don't love this. I don't love the thing on its head. If that was a little bit less weird, it would look awesome. Because it's like this proper suit of armor. It's very cool. But I think the weird frill ruins it. It kind of looks like something from Stargate SG-1 or Star Trek or Star Wars or Star... Every other program with Star in the title, basically. How are you doing, Tujanga? You're very cool as well. And finally, ladies and gentlemen, the most exciting one, I think we'll all agree. If I can find the little bugger. Where are you? There? Yes. Level 10. Level 20. Oh look, it's level 30 and it's red. Oh god. Hoping for a permanent big thrill. If not, as long as he does that every now and again, that's okay. He or she? I wonder why I call certain dinosaurs she. Because they're not all by default female in Jurassic World. Well, I assume they're not, it's never mentioned. And obviously, what would be the point? They know from the first part that that didn't work. So I assume the gender isn't as controlled. If anything, they probably want to breed the dinosaurs so they can sell them off or make a dinosaur army and what have you. Interesting. Dilophosaurus, stop giving me trouble, you. No problem, folks, for this. I don't really know where to go after this in terms of what to level up. I'm thinking we need to try to get four level 40 legendaries. I think that's going to be the next goal. And because of that, I think we're going to focus on ones that I need for hybridization anyway. So like Sarcosuchus, and it doesn't count with herbivores, but we can get Unasaurus level 40. Pteranodon, which is quite close as well, as a Sarcosuchus, and then probably the T-Rex. I think that's the right way to go about it. You agree? Hopefully you agree. Agree with me? Because we don't have any level 40 legendaries at the moment. And it makes you a little bit weaker. You know, there's a couple of battles where I've been up against the top level legendaries. I just think if I had one of each, we'd be a lot more sorted in battles. I don't blame it, no. Hello, you're strange. You're really weird looking. I need you to get the frill out so you look a little less weird. I'm gonna give you some food to see if that helps. You're bizarre. What are you doing? Maybe if I poke it. I'm gonna poke it. Get it out! Whip it out, what are you doing? Okay, maybe I need to poke it in the head. Okay, that's not doing anything. Yeah. Everywhere I touch it, it does the same thing. How much are you self off? Yeah, quite a lot. Not bad. Nope, give up. Well, we saw the frill before. Why is it being all weird? Huh. Get your frill out for the lads. Why are you being weird? Mm-mm. Stop it! Whatever, I didn't like you anyway. Thank God that's done. To conclude, Dr. Wu, I think you're more concerned about the secrecy of Project Eris than its integrity. Security, Larry. I'm concerned about security. Everyone's concerned, everyone's angry, ends now. Oh. I finished. The game is over. How does that make any sense? Tell you what, we'll do what we always do. We'll hop out and we'll hop back in. Just in case it's bugged out. Because the last battle mission I had was level 48, so why would the... Huh. Okay then. Well, that's every mission in the game done, apparently. I'm expecting updates, I'm expecting more to be added. Oh yeah, Unisur is still fate now, by the way. I am expecting more to be added, but... Huh, I didn't expect to hit it so soon. This is the thing, right? So level 40 Dimetrodon would make a lot more sense than level 40 T-Rex. T-Rex is nowhere near. T-Rex needs 5 more. Dimetrodon, actually, yeah, this makes more sense. We'll get a level 40 Dimetrodon, a level 40 Trinodon, a level 40 Sarcosuchus, and a level 40 Unesaurus. That's our next big set of goals. And then we can get the hybrid Sarcosuchus and the hybrid Terrizzo hybrid Trinodon? Maybe. I think that's the next plan. Is that a plan? That kind of sounds like a plan. Tropical fruit. So the park is looking pretty colourful. It is going to be a little while to the next episode, just because there's very little to do. I don't want to do that. I want to do that. Okay, what if we go? Oh, we're going to see Dimetrodon. Very exciting. So we need Dimetrodon first, then we need Pteranodon, right? Yeah, so this is what I'm thinking. So we'd have Pteranodon's bottom left, pterosaurs, I should say. Pterosaurs bottom left, amphibians top left, carnivores bottom right. Wait, no. Carnivores top right, herbivores bottom right. So it's like that top left beats top bottom right beats bottom left. Yeah, it's like an order, it's like a thing with the hybrids in the middle. Did I get that right? Yeah, I don't know. No room for you, Unesaurus. Boop! But here, if I had three level 40, if I had them all at level 40, I mean, I'm confident just because the type advantage is probably going to lead to a win here. Although he's going to swap out, isn't he? Because it, yeah. The type advantage is still probably going to lead to a win, but if these were all level 40, I'd be a lot more confident. This always goes like this, every single time. It's more about who blinks first. And because you go first, I tend to win. I have to hope. He's going to swap out, he's in the gap at one point. Maybe he'll attack me. Yeah. It's not a big deal. Now I know he has no points, we can swap to Dimetrodon, we can kill Unesaurus. Like so, and still save a point. And now we win. We just win. Now, we're done now, we're finished. Unless he doesn't spend many points. Hopefully he spends like 3 attack. They always do this, they're a little bit daft sometimes, you know? Not my poor Dimetrodon, no. Trondon comes out. Kills this in one hit because that guy's got no attack power. It's no problem. Oh, meh. Now, I did actually do another common one. That's where we got the Triceratops from. They saw it at the start of the video. Oh, right. Oh, it's so cool! Yeah, we're definitely getting a Dimetrodon. Look at it! It's awesome! Really cool. Yep, Dimetrodon is our next goal. Dimetrodon, Sarcosuchus, Pteranodon, Unesaurus in that order. If we do all that, then we can start looking at some of the other hybrids. I think that's the plan. It just doesn't make sense to go for a T-Rex when I'm so close to having a level 40 carnivore legendary, you know? It's a Tua Janga 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 Janga. Our next one is going to be a rare. The next video is probably going to start when that becomes a legendary. At this point, folks, there's nothing more to show you guys. I can't just, like, it's going to take a little while to get all these legendaries ready. Even just to get the 2 more Dimetrodons we need is going to take a decent amount of time. You know, it's going to be about getting these mystery packs when they appear every sort of 7-6 hours, whatever it is. Other than that, I don't really know what to show you guys. So it's going to be longer between each episode. However, whenever there's like a weekend challenge or something like that, when they do the big events and stuff like that, we'll definitely join in. If anything changes, if anything gets added to the game, whatever, we'll definitely do update videos and stuff like that. And hopefully next video we can have a Dimetrodon ready maybe, and then we'll go ahead and do some battle arena and stuff. Thank you very much for joining me as per usual. I shall see you lovely people in the next episode. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye bye.